Welcome back to our channel. In this video, let us see how to draw the avatars displayed in the screen. It has two objects. One is the leaf, the other one is the rose. They are drawn using mathematical formulas and plotted in Matplotlib. Before seeing how to draw this in Python, please subscribe to our channel. First, we will see how to get the leaf. This is based on Barnsley's fern. This provides four functions. As we can see in the table, four functions are f1, f2, f3 and f4, and the probability to choose these functions are provided by the parameter p in the table. 0.01 times it's the stem portion, 0.85 times it's the smaller leaflets, and 0.07 times on the left hand leaflet and the right hand leaflet. Directly coming to the Python code for implementing Barnsley's leaf, we have a NumPy and Matplotlib imported, and also I have the random to generate random value. It is good to make the axis off for these drawings, and I am setting the face color to cyan over the background color black. As mentioned, first we will draw the leaf based on Barnsley's fern. Let me initialize x and y as a list with 0. Since we have to plot the fern, let me do this for say 2000 times. So for I in range 0 to 2000, so 2000 times, let us repeat this procedure. And the first one is get the random integer value which is between 1 and 100. If we remember, probability factor shall decide which function to be used to draw the leaf, either stem, large leaflets, or left and right smaller leaflets. So I'm converting it into a percentage, whole percent, 1 to 100 value. So if z is 1, where the probability mentioned is 0.01, x shall be appended with 0 and y list shall be appended with 0.16 times the y of I, where I ranging from 0 to 2000 here. Similarly, when z is between 2 to 86, we will use f2 function, and when z is greater than 87 to 93, we will use f3 function, which is nothing but the left hand side of the largest leaflets. And so on, we will also draw for the largest leaflets on the right side when z is greater than 94 but less than 100. So this way, based on random values ranging from 1 to 100, we will be able to get the leaf by choosing correct function, which is f1, f2, f3 and f4. And the values are appended to the list x and y. On having these x and y values appended for 2000 samples, we can go and plot it. As the values will be scattered, naturally we will call the scatter plot and pass x and y parameter. We will also give color for the leaf as 0937 and 370F. Now let us execute this code. Before executing, we want this to be shown, so I'll call show method. There is one invalid syntax error is coming up. Okay, I have used semicolon in the assignment line row 17. I have removed that semicolon. Once again, we will try to run it. I think there is one more error. Instead of conditional check if is equal to 1, I have given an assignment. Hope it compiles successfully. Yes, we got the leaf which is based on Barnsley's fern, which takes the value for x and y based on the probability of random value ranging from 1 to 100. So we can also try changing the number of samples. Now I ranging from 0 to 4000, the leaf will be much, you know, very dense leaf we can get it. After having this leaf plotted, now we will proceed with drawing the rose flower. For that, the mathematical rose is a curve of sinusoid specified by either cosine or sine function with no phase angle, that is plotted in polar coordinates. So on going further, we will see the formula specification for drawing this mathematical rose. Here r equal to a cosine of k theta, where k is a rational number. We will see k further, theta varying from 0 to 2 pi, and a is a constant value, and x and y are provided as a function of r cosine theta and r sine theta. R can take a value of a sine k theta or a cos k theta. When the value of k is equal to 4, that is even number, the number of petals in the rose will be doubled. When the value of k is 7, that is odd number, the number of petals is same as the k value. So having these specifications for r equal to a sine k theta, we can proceed to draw our rose and plot it in Matplotlib. So first r is equal to a cos k theta, where theta will vary from 0 to 2 pi. So I'll take value of theta, say I'll take 1000 samples between 0 to 2 pi using the Lin space, so that the samples will be equally spaced between 0 to 2 pi. And r equal to 3 times the n sine, I'll take even number 6 theta, so that the number of petals will be 2 times the even number. So since 6 is the value, we will have 12 petals. And I have taken the value of a is 3. So r equal to 3 times the sine of 6 theta. X1 is r times the cos theta, and y1 is equal to r times the sine theta. As we are going to plot both rose and the leaf in the same plot, we are not creating the figure once again. In the same plot, we are plotting it. We got the rose also along with the leaf, but only thing is we want the rose overlap the leaf. For that, we have to use z order parameter passing to our scatter and plot. When z order is higher, that will be placed above the other things. So to have the rose above, I'll give z order of 10 for the rose, which is greater than z order of 1 for scatter. Now on, if we see our complete code, I have imported the packages. First we are drawing the fern, which is based on the probability for 1 out of 4 functions will be taken, and using a mathematical rose formula, we are also getting x1, y1 coordinates for the rose, which is nothing but cosine and sine of theta. Now we can see rose is above the fern, which is an interesting art we got and plotted with Matplotlib.